Hello. In this lecture, we will study about the Lorentz magnetic force. A current carrying conductor, when placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a force, which means that the charge moving in a magnetic field experiences the force, which is given as QV cross B, where F is the force experienced by the charged particle. V is the velocity with which the particle is moving, and B is the magnetic field, direction of the magnetic field. Now see the diagram. It is a plane, and the magnetic field is acting in this plane. Q is a positive charge which is moving with the velocity v at some angle theta with the direction of the magnetic field. As the current is moving in the same direction, or we can say the current is due to the motion of the positive charge, so direction of the current is the same as the direction of the motion of the positive charge. As the current also produces a magnetic field, so because of the presence of the two field, the charge experiences a net force, and that force is given as QV cross B. It is a vector product of the velocity and the magnetic field. As it is a vector product, so the force is perpendicular to the plane containing V and B. V and B are in this green plane, so the force is perpendicular to this plane. Now see, the force is perpendicular to the plane. As it is a vector product, so this can be written as QVB sine theta. N is a unit vector in the direction of the F. Now, in a second diagram, the charged particle is negative. Instead of the positive charge, here the charged particle is now negative. So, direction of the current is opposite to the motion of the charged particle. Charged particle is moving in this direction and the current is in opposite direction. So, in this case, the force is also perpendicular, but it acts in downward direction. Now the special cases, as F is equal to QVB sine theta. Now the first case, when the charge is at rest, it means velocity is zero. When we put here the velocity is zero, then the force on the charged particle is zero. It means no force is acting due to the motion of the charge, and the charged particle goes undeviated. Now the next, when the charged particle is moving parallel or anti-parallel to the magnetic field, means charged particle is moving either in this way or in this way. When it is moving in the direction of magnetic field, at that time theta is zero. When it is moving in opposite direction, then the theta is 180 degrees. And you know very well the value of the sine 0 and the sine 180 is zero. So the force is zero. Means in this case also, no force is acting on the charged particle. Now the third case, when the angle charged particle is moving at right angle, if it is moving in this way, or this angle is 90 degree. As the theta is 90 degree, it means the sine 90, this value is 1. And the force on the charged particle is BQV, and you know it is a maximum force on the charged particle. And in this case, the direction of the force is given by the Fleming's left hand rule. Now, what is the Fleming's left hand rule? If we stretch the thumb, central finger, and sorry, forefinger and the central finger of our right of our left hand in such a way they are mutually perpendicular to each other. Then central finger points in the direction of the current, forefinger points in the direction of the magnetic field, then thumb gives the direction of motion or the direction of the force on the current carrying conductor. Now see, if this finger points in the direction of the current, forefinger points in the direction of the magnetic field, then thumb gives the direction of the force experienced by the charge conductor. Now to make it more clear, here the magnetic field is produced by using the two bar magnets, North Pole and South Pole. So the magnetic field is produced here. So the direction of the magnetic field is this one. It is the direction of magnetic field. It is a conductor and the current is flowing in this conductor. So this finger points in the direction of the current. This finger points in the direction of magnetic field. So the force on this conductor is acting in the direction of the thumb, that is in the upward direction. Now force on a moving charge in a uniform electric and a magnetic field. Till now we have discussed that when the charge particle is present only in the electric field or the charge particle is present in magnetic field. Now what happens if both the electric and the magnetic fields are present in a region? Now when there is only the electric field, then the force on the charge particle is given by this relation. When there is only the magnetic field, then the force on the charge particle is given by this relation. The net force on the charge particle when both the fields are present is the sum of the electric force and the sum of the magnetic force. So the net force is equal to the sum of these two forces. Taking the Q common, this can be written as, so it is a Lorentz force, this is called Lorentz electric force, this one is called Lorentz magnetic force. Now let us discuss some special cases. Case 1, when the velocity of the particle, electric field and magnetic field all are in the same direction. When all are in the same direction, it means the velocity and the magnetic field are in the same direction. Charge particle is moving parallel to the magnetic field, and in this case, the force on the particle due to the magnetic field is zero, and only the force is due to the electric field, that is the force is the electric force, and the charge will accelerate. As the charge is accelerating, in this case, the speed of the particle, kinetic energy, velocity, momentum, all these quantities changes. Now the second case, when V, E and B are mutually perpendicular. Now look at this diagram. The electric field is acting along the Y direction and particle is moving along the X direction, and the magnetic field is along the Z direction. Now, in this case, the electric and magnetic forces are acting along the same directions. Here, the magnetic field and velocity is perpendicular. So the magnetic force is acting along the Y direction and electric force is already in the Y direction. Here the electric force is QE and it is along the Y direction. Magnetic force is given by QV cross B and it is also acting along the Y direction. Net force is the sum of these two forces. So this can be written in this way. Negative sign means electric and the magnetic forces acts in opposite direction. And J component shows these forces are along the